All right, let's give Dragonshard a look.
Ah, some high fantasy. Finally.
Yeah, buddy, you don't know the half of it.
Oh my gosh.
I want what these guys were smoking.
Dragonshard is usually I have one of those after Taco Bell.
When I woke up, nothing was as it should have been. The few clues I found
it's Dragon Braille
led me here. I encountered no one except nameless foes bent on my destruction.
Oh my god. He's dead.
When I finally arrived, I had no words for what I found.
The medieval button from Portal.
Now I know what to do. I will put this world back
together. I don't know about you guys. That is exactly how I imagine a dragon sounding.
They speak with great diction in a female voice.
Mm-hmm. A disinterested female voice.
Here's the thing. I had high hopes for this, and I still do. Because in Dragon Age Inquisition, you actually collect shards, and there are dragons. So I thought maybe it'd be like tangentially related.
They hit all the high notes.
You play Dragon Age Inquisition?
Oh, you don't even know.
I heard you could jump in that game.
You can. And get and clip into so many things.
Oh, wow.
It's great.
Sounds like a good time. What is not a good time here is only having $230 out of $184,000.
Wow.
They still got time. They still got time. It's still got right. time.
That's a guy.
Hey, you know, aim for the moon, because why not? You'll still end up among the stars.
Can dragons fly to the moon?
Yes.
Apparently, they can rebuild a planet torn apart by the description here. The video is kind of lacking in explaining about anything, but I guess this is kind of like SimCity, except you're a dragon mayor.
What?
How do you know? All I know about it is that there's foes that stand in your way. Oh, no.
Oh, this might help.
Ooh.
Robert here from Potable Games. I'm here with my friend Creighton to introduce this
like
game
me and
that
Judge
we
recording
want to make for you all.
Podcast.
A game called Dragonshard.
We all pass around a handheld mic.
Hey, I'm Creighton Metzger. My primary focus is on scripts and animations. Very excited
Great job.
To be working on this game.
All right. Well, the gameplay that we are expecting to introduce in this first stage of funding is going to be a single endless dungeon, one where you travel down fighting different enemies along the way.
The guy on the right is the muscle of the group. He's there just to make sure you don't get out of line hearing this pitch.
And
the muscle that does art assets.
Different pieces of the maps will be spliced in, depending on what skills you have on the at the time. One thing that you do is, after fighting your way down, you find yourself at a boss.
That guy on the right funded that badass boss, babes game.
You can upgrade your skills, hey. And if it was a little difficult for you in the first run, you can make it a little easier. Or if it was really
what is
easy,
any hot breath dragon like?
Incredibly hard,
babes.
One thing that is really fun about this is you're going to have not only the opportunity to challenge yourself.
He's bored with his own premise.
Against your friends' abilities and their ability to get further down. And so as you get more power,
it'd be cool
ups,
if the guy on the right just started dosing off.
You can increase your difficulty settings and really
and his snoring made little fire bubbles because he's a dragon. He's secretly a dragon.
I'm gonna
he sleeps on a pile of gold to keep his belly cool.
About the art in this game.
The level design
had to fade out there as a bad cut. Aspects.
They did 150 takes. This was the best one.
Ancient ruin or lava caverns. We'll have 10 different enemy types, each one focused on being
the
a
dragon.
Unique battle experience.
I'm sorry, can I start over?
For example, some enemies you may
save need for the blooper reel.
Instead of attacking them first. And other enemies, you may need to launch an all-out offensive immediately or you're going to encounter trouble. And then when you start mixing these enemies in the level, you're going to have to come up with new tactics in order to properly fight all
so
of them.
So like any
once.
Other game ever in the history of video games.
This one has dragons in it.
And enemies.
That sets it above it.
Thanks for watching this video and participating in our Kickstarter. We look forward to seeing you in the credits.
I'm just assuming we funded it.
Bad assumption. Don't fund it.
Ooh, I don't like being told what to do.
Yeah. Ooh, $10, you get coin purse. Concept art. Oh, $5 swagger. YOLO swag, as the kids say.
Ah. Pledge game on Fleek.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you get Drake at $40.
Man, that's pretty cheap.
Wow, I want to go. Okay. So I like that pledge level. Oh, love Drake. I love him. I love his love for BBW.
Are you a beta Drake or an alpha Drake kind of guy? Or just regular Drake?
Regular Drake.
Okay.
The one from the Great North.
Zeta Drake.
Is it Zeta Drake?
Yeah.
And
those are the three Greek letters I know.
Much like Drake, this game takes a world, starts from the bottom, and now we're here. I like the idea of building a world as a dragon. Unlike you guys, you can't see the vision. That's because you don't have dragon eyes like me.
The big, beautiful dragons.
You can't see the vision of this game like I can. And I'm going to fund it because I think it'll be fun. I think those interesting guys, you know, laid out some wild concepts. So, what is this game called? Dragon's Heart.
Dragon Island. It's called Dragon's Heart.
Dragon's Heart. Fund it. Back it.
All right. What about you, Tom? You'll be the deciding dragon.
So I'm really upset that Chris brought up the fact that I don't have dragon eyes. It haunts me every day. I lie awake screaming, and then I go to the 24-hour stripper joint in audition, and I get turned down every night.
It says no dragons.
Here's the thing. I think there's a lot of potential in the story.
Unquestionably.
I'm a little worried about the execution, but I think we've seen, you know, there's been an explosion of interest in high fantasy lately with
Hobbit.
With the Hobbits and Game of Swords.
Spider-Man.
The Spider-Man. Fund it.
Wow.
Yes. Fund it. Yes. I'm excited about that one, guys. Girl Amazon Survival. Tell me what it's all about.
I think we kind of got it already.
This is HD. Did you see that?
Is this lady so tiny that she's as small as a flower?
Wait,
Rust?
Minecraft?
No, it's Rust.
This is Rust.
No, it's Z1N1.
Oh, watch out, Timber!
Oh, no!
That was a shameless attempt to get some side boob off of the Amazon. Oh, it's like
Oh,
Lost.
My God.
There's a tree growing through the wing of the plane, as Shatner said.
Oh, who are those guys?
Oh, zombies in a video game. Bold choice. When are they going to go with mummies? Or Frankensteins.
Or Yetis. Whoa.
Wow.
That stone man.
Here's the thing. This game will do great on Android. It will kill on Android.
Unquestionably.
Yeah, without a doubt. Without a doubt.
What else are you going to play? Even the Monument Valley guy said he made no money. Yeah, he got nothing to play.
And his game was played on the House of Cards.
Yeah.
I think.
Season 3. I've never watched that show.
Yeah, yeah. I've never seen Lost either. You seen Lost?
No. I know things about it tangentially through like pop culture.
Okay. So knowing what you know tangentially about Lost, what is your take on this game? Amazon Survival Girl.
Do yourself an axe to defend.
Yeah.
Kill animals, roast meat on a fire. It will prolong your life. That's just good advice.
Hey, so, Tom.
Huh. Already established players. I've been pretty established on this server for a while. I've grown from an Amazon girl to an Amazon woman.
I mean, I heard about all the bear attacks that were a pivotal part of Lost. Every week they had to fight off a new bear that for whatever reason would stand like 2 feet away from them and just like flail all its limbs wildly and never hit them.
You think that's wild? You should have seen the episode where the hogs came.
I heard it was a metaphor for purgatory.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
The bears. Just the bears.
It was spooky. Three spooky.
Wait, how are the bears? So, like, the bears are in between heaven and hell?
Yeah.
I don't know. It was way too high concept for me. I gave up. There were bears, and, like, you had to chop wood.
This is Lost or Amazon Girl?
Lost.
Okay. Amazon Survival Girl, you're still with?
Oh, I'm still with. I totally get this. I mean, this is pretty self-explanatory. Mm-hmm. You cook some meat and eat it. I mean, come on. But what am I, like, doing chores here? Like, give me a break. I gotta do that in my real life.
I have to cook meat on a fire.
Yeah, give me a break. I don't have time for this. We already established earlier that I don't have enough time to, like, look at porn and watch video games.
Much less cook meat.
And then I have to feed myself. There's only so many hours in the day.
Yep. Preach. I mean, you're preaching to the choir here.
Amen. Wow.
So,
fund it or no?
Don't fund it.
Okay.
Oh, I forgot we were doing that.
Yeah. We...
I'm going to have to echo the sentiment of Major Riggs here and say, I don't think you can have too many games where the main character is a female. So fund it.
Well, yeah, we're bridging gaps here. We're bringing people together. There is that. There's that going for it. So, strong female lead character. Mm-hmm. I like it.
So speaking
don't
of
fund
that,
it.
Don't fund it, though. Don't. Yeah. Speaking of that, strong female character fighting bears. It's a... It's an homage, as they say, to the original strong female character fighting bears. Lara Croft.
Of course.
Yeah, who, I don't know if you know the history, was programmed by the programmer.
As programmers are wont to do in their spare time.
Because he was tired of looking at the character model. He wanted to look at something a little more easy on the eyes.
Oh, boy.
So I think the concept of this game is that they want to make Rust, or DayZ, but a little easier on the eyes. Don't fund it.
Here, interesting gameplay twist. What if they made her super fat? Fund it or no fund it?
Fund it.
Fund it.
Good. I'm with a good group of guys here.
We like our girls BBW.
Games for the people. !!
Why does nobody capitalize things in their titles? It drives me so nuts. Why is people not capitalized?
$200,000. $1. So close.
How many backers has he got?
One.
Oh no, it's done. It ended 3 hours ago.
Well, let's try to see where it went
let's
wrong.
Let's see what we're missing.
Let's do like a post-game analysis.
Ooh, post-mortem.
Yeah.
Hey everybody, my name's Jeff. I am the main head behind Astral Glade. I'm just letting y'all know that I'm going to be with y'all every step of the way this is developed, and I'm going to post everything that I can on Facebook.
What's that about 9/11 behind him?
To show you videos as the game is developed.
We don't call 911.
Now, I'm going to let y'all know.
We don't believe 9/11 happened. That's what it says.
You're the people who are helping support this, and I want you to be with me 100% of the way. I want this game to be just as much a part of your life as it is mine. I've been developing this game since 1997. I have come up with many, many ideas.
All right, Judge, pause.
I just want this game to be perfect.
What do you think this game is that he wants to be a part of your life? What do you think it's about?
Well, we know it's not about cooking meat.
Do you know that?
Proper beard maintenance?
Okay.
I mean, since 1997, some sort of Janine Garofalo tie-in.
I'm going to say some... Friends-related video game?
About like the show Friends?
About
or
the show Friends? Like an adventure game where you play as Ross your pet monkey was stolen and you have to get him back?
He poops and chews. All right, let's find out. Okay. Let's find out.
Now, perfection isn't everything, but I want this game to be as perfect as possible, and I want y'all to experience this game in a way that nobody else will. I want y'all to
ain't it true?
Know that
no one's going to experience it.
I appreciate everybody who's going to support this. And this is just a lot of love, guys. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, now here comes the game.
It's over. I can start. I think his vision for this game sounds great. He says he's been working on it since 1997. It's been in his head since then. He's been kicking
he's had
it
a lot of ideas. Now, it's like, I should use a controller.
So here's the description. A game that combines all the best of the RPG genre and turns it on its head to make it something amazing. It should be a good thing.
Capital A should. So it's been in his head since 1997. It combines all the best of the RPG genre.
It's a pretty tall order.
You know, I'm thinking that this young, bearded fellow once played a game called Final Fantasy VII in 1997 when it came out.
Oh boy.
And he was so moved by the one-winged angel and Sephiroth and that whole fight.
Who couldn't be?
That he's like, you know what? One day I'm going to make an RPG game. And then as things went on, he played more RPGs. He's like, you know what? All these games are the same. I'm going to take them all, combine what I like about all of them, and then flip the script, turn it on its head.
Wow.
What if green potions hurt you?
That is the kind of madness that he is welcoming us to in this paragraph.
He came up with that in 2004.
Wow. he wrote it down in a notebook.
RPG notebook.
Yeah, it's one of those 70-page notebooks.
He was looking at the color wheel, and he's like, green is the opposite of red. I've got it.
And then two years later, 2006.
2 years later.
He says to himself.
He brought it all together.
He says to himself, what if summons were regular attacks and attacks were summons?
I can't.
Exactly. He busted out that loose leaf notebook and he wrote it down.
Top Hat the Fire Cat. I will still laugh that one of my boss's names is Top Hat the Fire Cat. I love it. Fund it.
So much wasted potential here.
Don't worry.
Here's the thing. I love these guys that are so unbelievably confident that what they have is the greatest thing ever that they dare ask for $200,000 on Kickstarter. I cannot believe that anybody would go on a site and ask for that much money without having a killer idea.
Or any proof.
or any tangential proof that you've been working on something for going on 16 years now?
I guess he has proof in that he thought of a boss called Top Hat the Fire Cat.
He has his RPG notebook where he's been writing down all the tropes he's going to turn on their heads. Mm-hmm.
Strength is actually intelligence.
He said, why do all bosses have to be scary?
Yeah, why do they gotta be spiders and dragons?
Why can't I, instead of fighting a boss, try and make him my friend?
Oh, it's his boss. Like his actual boss.
Yeah. Right?
Isn't that what he said? It was like
it used to be his teachers back in 97.
Uh-huh.
And then he erased that and he put bosses down because he's older now and he's got a bigger worldview.
Uh-huh. He hates that chef at Applebee's he works at.
Bartender won't give him a beer and a shot at the same time. He's an adult. He should be able to get a beer and a shot at the same time.
He says, come on, Top Hat Fire Cat. Give me a beer and a shot. That's what he says.
That's all I can think about when anybody talks about Applebee's, because my dad refused to drink there once because they would not give him a beer and a shot at the same time. They said, this is a family establishment and we don't do that. He said, what if I ordered a beer and then immediately ordered a shot and then drank them both at the same time? Well, you could do that. You could do that. It doesn't make any sense.
This is a family establishment. They told him that. It was a family establishment.
They said, we can't do that. This Applebee's is for the children.
Don't you see the tchotchkes on the wall?
That's what they said. We're not some kind of alcohol bar. Get out. So my dad left.
And then he said, from this day forward, you shall remember me as Top Hat Fire Cat.
A young man was listening at a nearby table with his loose leaf paper. He's like, I have it.
I want it.
It's like some Paul Harvey story. I love this.
I hope that guy puts another Kickstarter up. Because I want to fund him.
You all remember Chrono Trigger, right?
Well, who doesn't?
Chrono Legends.
What about the sequel, Chrono Cross?
That never happened.
I
hate that game.
All right, and play.
Are we on? Okay. Well, I'm here to talk about what's happening in Chrono Legends 1999.
Chrono?
Well, first thing is that,
hey, leave Michael Gamorous alone. He's friend to children.
And so
Michael A.
It was really fun to put together and have all the comments.
Yeah, it seems like it was a riot.
The fans look at the project that we came up with.
I feel like there should be a pot leaf in like the top right corner.
Well, it was more of an idea.
Was he supposed to see, we wanted eventually to go into the center of the halo?
Things happen.
It's clearly an eclipse.
And so,
like Pink Floyd, Dark Side of the Moon.
You have an idea.
Yeah, if you actually play this video really with big, the fight with Lavos, it syncs up.
You should expand off of it and you keep going with that.
360-degree movement! So,
finally!
Wow!
Up and until now, only 359.
Well, there it goes. No, it just left the screen.
Well, here it comes back.
Yeah.
It has it's referring to itself. It has the 360 degrees of movement.
I don't know. I think it's just degree movement for the Xbox 360 version.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's true. It isn't parenthetical.
We did last year with that.
Oh, I still talk.
Hold on. So, let's see exactly where that was. So, that was on YouTube.
He rehearses 50 times.
I don't have a glass on it, so I can't really see all that great. So I'm trying to show you that video.
Ah, where is that video I meant to show you?
Yeah, I think it's in my pantry.
Cut it, print it, put it on Kickstarter.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, let me go into my display settings.
What program is this?
Let me stop it right there, because...
He's using that, it's like that thing in the, that movie, Minority Report.
Who remade this? This is like a
colony. This is like some weird fever dream. He's got, like, windows over windows. He's clearly playing two different audio tracks at the same time, on top of his voice.
This is what we call a mashup,
so far-fetched that...
Ah, see, I'm not on Vine enough to get that.
So, I think what's going on here is that there's this other group of people who make fun of Kickstarters. They stole the idea from us, called Retsu Prey. And they made fun of this guy's previous projects, so now he's just watching their video while he's doing the Kickstarter. I think he, like, forgot what he was doing. And eventually he just starts vacuuming. He's like, I've left this on.
Take off your imagination, Flo? What the? What did that say?
Yeah, do it. Take off your imagination, Flo.
I said 61%. I made 61%.
Yep.
What?
All right, this is all in the video. I didn't do anything.
Please do not adjust your TV.
More tech, more deals, more savings.
What?
With 500
we're still
deals
here.
At fries.com
we're still here.
Deals. Check out the savings and find perfect
solutions. We're not sponsored by Fry's.
Pause it.
Fry's so promo code sale continues.
Don't go to Fry's.
God, we still have like 7 minutes left.
Of pure insanity.
Oh, wow.
All right, let's just regroup for a second.
All right, let's get past the Fries ad.
Every day when you sign
this
up at
Fries. This coffee break is brought to you by Fries.
Up, get savings up to 50% and more. Fries will send daily promo codes that will blow you away. And they're only available when you go to Fries.
Sign up in the comments of this video for
and
free
remember,
promo codes from Fries.
Use Men Drinking Coffee to get 5% off your Monster cable.
Can they say Best Buy?
So,
and we're back.
Yeah, 61% was probably
done. Wow.
With,
was he talking through the Fry's commercial?
Did he think they were like just gonna give him money if he put their ad in there?
I think I understand what happened. I think he was recording this to Twitch and then he downloaded the Twitch version. That's how that ad got in there.
Wow.
Just lap it on. So
I think I have to download the app to see what happened during the commercial.
He's just watching the video silently.
Oh, he just smirked. Oh, this guy's great. This guy's a star. Oh.
Michael A. Gamarus.
Okay, those were test scenes. They were never...
he's debunking the Retsu Prey.
...in the actual release. But anything you put on the public can be used as an actual release. I guess. And so,
ooh, what is this delightful bouncing text coming in?
It's the longest word in the English language. The in-game IRC chat features.
Kind of nature.
Oh, you could use IRC. Chrono can talk to Marla on IRC and slap her with a fish. Now, here it comes again.
Technical difficulties.
Is this guy green screening his actual room behind him?
I guess they don't know how to use a camera, you know. As the children that they are, through the vocabulary that I can hear.
Oh no, he's feeding the trolls.
That,
Were there trolls in Chrono Trigger, Judge?
There are in the IRC window.
Challenging for the fun of everything that's put on. And so, you know, to me, that's just a child of mine.
This timeline.
That's right.
You know, it's a child world out there, I agree.
It's a whole new epoch in IRC.
And an adult perspective, it's very challenging.
Look at he's being attacked by skeletons in the corner. Chrono's fighting skeletons. Blender skeletons.
Those bones are moving.
Let me see if I can come up a little bit. So first thing, right.
Alright, not again.
No, I like it.
We're not doing another fry smash, though. Not without getting paid. Sign me
up. You away. Oh, wait, we're back.
You can find it with the links that are
right where we left them.
Basically,
yeah, I told you we didn't have to put them in the cage when we left.
We have four new members. And so
you can't cage Michael Gamorous.
Last year has grown. So
a lot of Unity windows in that taskbar.
That are on Facebook and are slowly developing.
When it says Chrono Legends 1999, that's how many versions of the game he's planning on releasing.
What was 2D that didn't work out so well?
That's how many versions he wants to support simultaneously. That's how many Unity windows he wants to be
open. Linux, Mac, PC, and Android.
I want the version that has the timeline where you go to the developers at the end and talk to the skeleton developers.
So, good. You have to beat Lavos at the first teleporter.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Now, Tom, you've never played the Chrono Trigger.
I haven't.
And do you care?
No.
Is this making you salivate? You're like, I can't wait to explore all this time traveling and fighting skeletons.
I just really want to talk to Michael and tell him it's going to be okay. Not to let the trolls get him down. And most importantly, not to feed them.
I agree with that sentiment. For some reason, Chrono's disappeared from the site. I'm not sure why. Maybe he went to go on to his own Unity build engine.
Where'd he go, Judge? You were supposed to watch him.
I'm sorry.
All this is
let him go.
He went back into the time portal, like his mom chasing the cat.
So some of the figures.
Maybe he became the cat.
Maybe he sneezed on the butterfly.
No. You never played the Chrono Cross.
I didn't. There's too many characters.
Become the cat. I believe Michael A. Gamorous is one of the characters in Chrono. He has his own custom accent.
That's the only thing they did to differentiate it. His thing was that he kept opening Unity Engine windows.
He was a really complicated, it's like an expert level player if you played with him. But you could use the glitch with his window opening ability to kill Lavos in one hit. Fries.
And he was sponsored by Fries. Over 500
weekly deals at fries.com. I don't know. I got to sign up. Check out the savings and find
perfect solutions for your. So I don't get it. Is Fries Electronics or French Fries? Continues every day when you sign up at
fries.com/signmeup. Get savings up to 50% and more. That's a good deal. Promo code will
blow you away. You can't pass up a deal, can you?
No, I can't.
Sign me up. You see, and we got something out of this pitch.
What if I told you about a deal called Chrono Legends 1999?
Sign me up.
A lot of us feel that it's necessary.
Damn, music in your game?
What is that Ferris wheel at the bottom? That looks cool.
That's one of the characters.
And so we picked up the project again after late October. And decided to go in a new perspective with the 3D way of doing things. So we're using a 3D application that is obviously free to use. It does have a license.
Ah, good.
Unity
4. I was curious how many testings they had. It turns out it's 1 million with a leading zero.
292,015.2. This is everything that.
I think there's a little bit of screen burn going on. I can still see the window.
It's a very long list that goes down.
Do you think he, like,
the development
was looking at his video? I was like, yeah, I was missing something. Something's missing. And he dragged that JPG of the. Eclipse over.
And he, it all
and he, like, he turned up the transparency to like 60%, and he's like, ah, this is it.
Perfect.
Finally.
Check out this JPG of my RPG.
Then he was like, I only got two fry ads in there. I better put a third one in just to be safe.
The third fry ad was a masterstroke, in my opinion.
Yeah, it's true. It's the rule of comedy.
All right. So, no, that 10 minutes flew by. So luckily, there's even more footage.
Let's hope for 15 more minutes.
Oh, just three.
Wow, this guy can afford two monitors. I don't know if he needs the money.
You quit smoking.
It's all the time travel. He takes it out of you. Come on, buddy. Disable UAC. This is the first time he's ever run it. Yep.
And I'm nervous.
Wait.
Oh.
You're going to fix that, right?
No.
We're good. We're good.
Oh, man.
I like that grass texture, though.
It really matches the stylistic.
Ah, here we go.
he hurt you.
This must have been the camera that the trolls were talking about.
Troll cam, they call it.
Ah, I see. He did decide to put music in there.
I think it's playing on the speaker.
I think Judge is right.
Yeah.
I think it's a boombox behind him.
Ah, cool.
The DeWalt boombox that just got done playing classical music.
Don't you dare speak those words.
You can run and walk.
Just like in the game.
360 degrees of movement. Did you not pay attention during that 10-minute
They really
rant?
They nailed the Chrono Trigger atmosphere.
Yeah, I did pay attention, Tom. He just threw a lot of big ideas at me. It almost seemed like too much. I'll be honest, this looks good.
I like how it shows you that everything is just on the surface.
Very immersive.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, what a room.
What is he doing?
Showing you can play with the controller.
Why did he strap the camera to his chest?
He's a police officer. Thanks, Obama.
Shows you cops can do good in this country.
The cursor is there to helpfully remind you where Chrono is.
In case you lose him. Hope he finds a town soon.
The music fits perfectly for what he's doing.
So it's like an action RPG, huh? So you can swipe.
It's an in-action RPG. Just loads up cat videos. Forgets to turn it off. Oh, look, the dolphins are kissing.
How are we supposed to know if he shut down his computer correctly or not?
You better lock it if you're going to walk away.
That's right.
You want someone to prank you.
He got that Dell monitor from Fry's.
Hey, 50% off.
With the promo code Lavos.
Ooh. Family and Friends Factory.
Yeah, a lot of baby friends.
Oh, look at that sword.
Wait, the roadmap is January of 2015. Wait. It's not over yet.
24 hours to go.
I like his project plan.
A tent project.
Do you think he uses Scrum?
Yeah, I think so. If you pledge $10, you get to be a part of his daily stand up.
Yeah. You can go all the sprint demos.
Oh yeah.
Those jokes were for a very select subset of people.
And they're going wild.
It's true.
As I was for this man's game. Look, you could play as the frog from Chrono Trigger.
I'm noticing a little bit of an inconsistency between the quality of the models.
Ooh, this game got amiibo. I like them amiibo.
Yeah, I know you do. You've been collecting them.
I'm outside Best Buys every day.
You should get your amiibos at Fry's.
That's right. 50% off.
With promo code Chrono Legend.
This is amazing. He's recording with OBS to show a video of him playing a video.
This is like this Kickstarter Inception. Like, what is happening?
It's a video of him opening a video in a video.
I am riveted.
Wait.
Oh, cool.
Oh, yeah.
This is a party. I feel like it's the Millennial Festival, or whatever it's called in Chrono Trigger. The Millennial Festival, right,
Jess? This is that Uptown Funk song, right?
Yeah. They stole it from Marvin Gaye.
That's right.
Yeah, how is the Robin Thicke lawsuit going to play for this guy's Kickstarter?
I don't know. Luckily, Chrono doesn't have any copyright. I know how to use the Unity engine.
It does give me a vote of confidence, though.
I mean, he does look like
he clearly knows what he's doing.
He knows what he's doing. This isn't his first time in the Unity.
Yeah, give the guy a break. Like, he's doing pretty good.
We've been giving him a break this whole time.
Wow, man.
It's these jerks.
Yeah.
These trolls.
That's right.
The Retsu Prey guys.
Should have never built IRC into the game and interface. Just asking for trouble.
That's his one slip up.
He tried to mod a guy and got kicked out of his own channel. It's a big tragedy. They called it the Great Insurrection of Chrono 1999.
It's all right. He'll be back. He'll X-slash them. That's a Chrono Trigger move, right?
Yeah, it is. You know, for somebody who claims to know so little, I find your knowledge suspect.
I played it once because people told me to play it when I was, like, in 8th grade. Older.
Tom's getting down.
Oh, we're going to the App Store.
Oh, that's his wish list. He needs to buy the frog. You see?
Oh.
Dude, we got some cowbell going on in this thing. This is like, the best part of this entire day so far.
It's calculated.
He's got to figure out if he can budget for this.
He's like, what is 5 plus 13?
I feel good backing a Kickstarter that is budget is run the same way that I do my monthly budget.
He's buying that wolf thing amiibo.
So when you get a digital copy, then they send the physical one to your house, right? That's how that works.
That's right, yeah.
Again, I have to point out that we're watching a video of him watching the video. Why did he just upload the video?
Are you getting mad? I'm enjoying it.
I'm not
mad. Why can't you just, like, open your mind?
I'm not mad. I just question the efficiency.
It's cool. It's like one big take, like the Birdman.
Yeah, you give this video an alternate title, it wins an Oscar.
So you call it like Chrono Legends 1999,
or
I don't got an or. If you got one, go ahead. We can spitball some ideas here.
The inevitable presence of time.
Lavos hot, don't touch the ground.
In parentheses?
Yeah.
Oscar.
Yeah. We're gonna go through this all, huh?
We don't have to. We have the magic.
Oh, we don't have to do anything.
We don't have to back this, but I'm going to.
That's right.
Oh.
Again.
He's making cubes.
This dude beats the hell out of all those guys that just uploaded videos of them talking about this great project. Clearly, he's working on something.
This guy, he put his money where his mouth is.
I don't know what those other guys are doing. I don't know what they're going to do with my money.
How many videos are they making of videos?
None. And that's a huge problem for me.
As far as we know. Wow.
So you're on board with this man, right?
I mean,
what is his name? Give me a name.
Gamorous.
Oh, yeah. That's right. How could I forget?
It was only plastered on that video for 10 minutes. There was so much going on, I couldn't focus on it.
So you're behind Michael Gamorous.
Who can't be?
Apparently
a man with this much He's only asking for $200.
Like Icarus.
Give him $200.
Like Icarus, he flew too close to the sun, demanding the outrageous fee of $200.
Like, I'm just not going to like order pizzas for a month and like give this man $200. I feel like the money is well much better spent that way.
Wait, your pizza budget is $200?
I weigh 600 pounds.
Wow. Wow.
Yeah, so, nobody funding this? So, Tom, just to get your point, you would back this for sure.
Absolutely. I would give him the full $200. and I might teach him how to directly upload videos to Kickstarter.
All right, hold on. Don't compromise his artistic integrity.
I'm just going to give him a couple of good life hacks.
So many people use the video recording software to record videos that they already made. They don't realize that the video could just be uploaded.
And then you increase your productivity. Theoretically by 100%, right?
It's a pretty good ratio.
I think that's how the math works.
No matter what it is.
Hold on, let me take out my calculator on my desktop.
Just tell Michael to keep it open on his desktop and he'll add it for you.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Good.
Yeah, so Michael Gamarus,
is there any doubt? I mean, is there any debate?
No, back it 100%. I love him. Don't let the trolls get you.
By the time this video is released, though, I'm afraid that the 24 hours would have passed. So those of you out there, hop into your epoch and travel back to 2015 and fund this bad boy.
Why don't you do this? Find his Twitter handle. Okay. Just send him a little love. Be like, hey, you're a good dude.
Yeah.
Just say that. Just. No trolling. Just
people got to be so, you know, negative on the internet.
Keep your head up, and you'll beat Lavos one day, or your figurative Lavos.
Mm-hmm.
Clearly, the Coca-Cola Super Bowl commercial taught us nothing, and that money was wasted.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
Yep, well said.
They might as well just flushed it down the damn toilet.
Fund it. Well, guys, I think we're going to call that a wrap. And Major Tom, you've passed with flying colors. you demonstrated consummate business acumen.
I ripped my pants.
You ripped your pants?
I yelled a lot.
For the sake of comedy, you ripped your pants.
I only half paid attention. It was fun.
Oh, you're like, you're paying half more than me.
Yeah.
Ooh. Hold on, let's ask Michael. Get your calculator, Michael.
So, join us, won't you, in the near future for high seas antics.